Plus, at Charles Maughan Toyota, we'll buy from you even if you don't buy from us. But it's 1 week only. It all ends Monday night.
So hurry to Charles Maughan Toyota under the giant flag.
8400 Research Boulevard. If you shop us, you'll save. We guarantee it.
My name is Chris Franzen. I'm a West Point graduate, a Vietnam veteran, a small business owner, and a grandfather. I'm worried about our children's future. We have big problems, and our state leadership is making them worse. Our future economy depends on an educated workforce, adequate water and energy, and roads and transit. But instead, they've defunded our schools, ignored our water, and are not building roads and transit systems. I'll work for bright solutions for all of us. Please mark your ballot for me, Chris Franzen, House District 47.
Now at Rooms to Go, save big on closeout top grain leather reclining living rooms from Action by Lane. Over 1,000 pieces you'd expect to pay hundreds more for, now specially priced during a Rooms to Go manufacturer's closeout and clearance sale. Only Rooms to Go could offer you this 5-piece dining set, including table and 4 side chairs with ultra-high seating for only $5.55. Just $5.55 during the Rooms to Go $300 million manufacturer's closeout and clearance sale.
Type. Watch. Learn. Investigate. Decide. Check. Plan. Witness. Anywhere. Any device. One address. KXAN.com. It's that easy to get your local news and weather fast. KXAN.com.
Continuing our coverage of this year's ballot, City of Austin Propositions 10 and 11 would establish a civil service commission to oversee employment and compensation practices for city employees. Joining us today is Joe Deshotel, the campaign manager for Props 10 and 11. Joe, thanks for being here today.
Yeah, absolutely.
This is a kind of a matter that deserves some explaining. It's a little more complicated maybe. So why civil service?
Well, civil service, I do want to make one correction that it will not affect the pay, how employees' compensation actually is. What this would do would create a independent commission of 5 individuals appointed by city council that would hear employee grievances. So whether they were hirings, firings, promotions, or some issue that an employee had within their department. This would actually create a commission that would be independent that would hear that, and then they would provide a final say about any decision that was made with an employee.
So currently we don't have that.
Currently we don't have a system with teeth in it. Basically what we have now is a system of a hearings officer, which is an independent person, but once they hear the employee's claim, they make a decision and a recommendation to city management. So far, city management has overturned that decision 100% of the time. And so what this would do would make the independent analysis final. And so it makes a more transparent system where we take it away from sort of that bureaucracy and put it in an independent, transparent commission so that really we think that would increase the transparency and efficiency of government by allowing the citizens to have a little closer, I guess,
connection or
Yeah, voters would be able to actually see what was going on within city government.
Yeah, which is something that they advocate is transparency in government.
Right, and we think this would absolutely increase transparency. And one way that we note that is in 2011, the city of Austin did a survey of their employees. About 80% said that they were proud to work for the city of Austin, but only 47% said that if they had an issue in their department, they feel that it would be handled fairly.
Interesting.
And so this literally directly addresses that issue.
Now, how does this compare with some other major cities, I guess, around the state and country?
Well, in fact, most major cities handled this issue back in the 70s and 80s in Texas. So Austin is the last major city in Texas that does not have this type of system in place.
And when would this take effect, assuming it passes?
The next day, they would begin formulating the commission.
Oh, so it would start immediately?
It would start immediately after the election.
And cost to taxpayers? Or
It would not raise taxes, but there is a cost that would be associated. But the analysis at about $250,000 a year is equivalent to the amount the city has been paying in lawsuits that have been filed against the city. And this should prevent those lawsuits because you actually would have a fair established system in place that would make a final judgment about these issues.
Hopefully level the playing field for some employees within the city and fight against political favoritism. So to speak.
That is the idea.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks so much for being with us today.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
All right. Props 10 and 11. Check them out on the ballot.